Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai Fehér. Today, we are going to do this, and this, and this. One of these applications is called a NERF. What is that? NERFs mean that we have a collection of photos like these, and magically create a video where we can fly through these photos. Yes, typically, scientists now use some sort of learning-based AI method to fill in all this information between these photos. This is something that sounded like science fiction just a couple years ago, and now, here we are. Now, these are mostly learning-based methods, therefore, these techniques need some training time. Wanna see how their results evolve over time? I surely do, so let's have a look together. This NERF paper was published about a year and a half, or 2 years ago. We typically have to wait for at least a few hours for something to happen. Then came the Planoxos paper with something that looks like black magic. Yes, that's right, this trains in a matter of minutes. And it was published just 2 months ago. Such improvement in just 2 years. But here is NVIDIA's new paper from about a month ago. And yes, I hear you asking, Károly, are you telling me that a 2-month-old paper of this caliber is going to be outperformed by a 1-month-old paper? Yes, that is exactly what I'm saying. Now, hold on to your papers and look here. With the new method, the training takes... what? Less time than I have to utter this sentence because it is already done. So, first, we wait from hours to days, then, 2 years later, it trains in minutes, and a month later, just a month later, it trains in a couple seconds. Basically, nearly instantly. And if we let it run for a bit longer, but still less than 2 minutes, it will not only outperform a naive technique, but will even provide better quality results than a previous method, while training for about 10 times quicker. That is absolutely incredible. I would say that this is swift progress in machine learning research, but that word will not cut it here. This is truly something else. But if that wasn't enough, nerfing is not the only thing this one can do. It can also approximate a gigapixel image. What is that? That is an image with tons of data in it, and the AI is asked to create a cheaper neural representation of this image. And we can just keep zooming in and zooming in, and we still find new details there. And if you have been holding on to your paper so far, now squeeze that paper, because what you see here is not the result, but the whole training process itself. Really? Yes, really. Did you see it? Well, did you blink? Because if you did, you almost certainly missed it. This was also trained from scratch, right in front of our eyes. But it's so quick that if you take just a moment to hold onto your papers a bit more tightly, and you already missed it. Once again, a couple papers before, this took several hours at the very least. That is outstanding. And if we were done here, I would already be very happy, but we are not done yet, not even close. It can still do 2 more amazing things. One, this is a neural sine distance field it has produced. That is a mapping from 3D coordinates in a virtual world to distance to a surface. Essentially, it learns the geometry of the object better because it knows what parts are inside and outside. And it is blazing fast. Surprisingly, even for objects with detailed geometry. And, my favorite, it can also do neural radiance caching. What is that? At the risk of simplifying the problem, essentially it is learning to perform a light transport simulation. It took me several years of research to be able to produce such a light simulation, so let's see how long it takes for the AI to learn to do this. Well, let's see. Holy mother of papers! NVIDIA, what are you doing? I give up. As you see, the pace of progress in AI and computer graphics research is absolutely incredible, and even better, it is accelerating over time. Things that were wishful thinking 10 years ago became not only possible, but are now easy over the span of just a couple of papers. I am stunned. What a time to be alive! This episode has been supported by Lambda GPU Cloud. If you're looking for inexpensive cloud GPUs for AI, check out Lambda GPU Cloud. They've recently launched Quadro RTX 6000, RTX 8000, and V100 instances, and hold on to your papers because Lambda GPU Cloud can cost less than half of AWS and Azure. Plus, they are the only cloud service with 48GB RTX 8000. Join researchers at organizations like Apple, MIT, and Caltech in using Lambda cloud instances, workstations, or servers. Make sure to go to lambdalabs.com/papers to sign up for one of their amazing GPU instances today. Our thanks to Lambda for their long-standing support and for helping us make better videos for you. Thanks for watching and for your generous support, and I'll see you next time.